So let's look at the difference between a molecule and a formula unit. So you can see these examples. These are molecules here, and over here we have crystal lattices made up of formula units. So that's a good start. The first thing we want to recognize is covalent bonds. Molecules have covalent, also called molecular bonds. That's made of two or more nonmetals. And the electrons in these bonds right here, they're shared. So we have a pair of electrons shared between atoms. Here we have a double bond, two pairs. So molecules have covalent bonds. For our formula unit, we have ionic bonds. That's made up of a metal and a nonmetal. And they're ionic bonds. They're made of positive and negative ions. So this right here is a formula unit from NaCl down here. So they're part of a bigger crystal lattice. You won't have just one formula unit by itself. It's always in a crystal. And because it's ionic, we have charged ions, positives and negatives, where for the molecule, these will be neutral. Let's take a closer look at NaCl here. So you can see it's made up of a pattern of this repeating formula unit. Sodium, chlorine, sodium, chlorine, sodium, chlorine. That's the crystal lattice we're talking about. And these formula units, they don't exist independently. But the important thing is we have a ratio that stays the same, 1:1. One sodium to one chlorine atom. So our formula unit, that's the lowest whole number ratio of ions in the crystal. For something like magnesium iodide down here, since it's MgI2, we have one magnesium, the small one here, for every two of these iodide ions here, the big ones. But the ratio, it's fixed. It doesn't change. So those are the main differences between a molecule and a formula unit. This is Dr. B. Thanks for watching.